Coming into the main event, I'll just get into this question here. Which one are the best boxers to study Coach Kenny, according to you? What are the best boxers?
It depends on what you're looking at. It's so many, it's millions of fighters, man. It's what you're looking at, what kind of defense you're looking at, what kind of offense, just study boxing, period. Just study the greats, pick up good habits.
That's good. That's a good answer. That's a good answer, Cole.
Pick
Perfect
up
answer.
good habits.
Getting into the main event, okay. David Avanesian and Jerome Boots Ennis. David Avanesian went, he went five with Terrence Crawford. Before that, he went the distance with Shane Mosley. What do you think? What do you think about this fight? Does Boots have to do more, do you think, than Crawford did?
No, Crawford and Boots is the A fighters, man. So all Boots have to do is be yourself. Be yourself. And let it fall in place.
Now, you believe because of Boots' style, his showmanship, he doesn't need to do it inside. All he needs to do is let it, like you said, just natural and just put on a show.
Just put on a show and knowing Boots, it won't go past five, four, three, and it's not him trying to outdo Terrence Crawford. That's just Boots, it's just his ability, man. He can do inside, outside, all around, top, bottom. He can do it. He can do it. I don't see him having no problems with this guy.
Is he one of the best boxers in the world today? Would you say that he's one of the more complete boxers today?
Yes.
Do you feel like Javon, I mean, do you feel like him and Crawford is one of the, I don't even
I
want to
think
put them in like one of the best. Yeah, go ahead.
him and Crawford is damn near equal, man, because they both switch hitters. Only difference between them two is age,
The only difference.
That is age. And they both have good habits outside of the ring. They both well mannered. You can't say nothing wrong about neither one of them. And that's a fight that I would just sit neutral in and watch and enjoy,
As a fan,
Yeah.
what would you, when looking at that fight, what do you expect as a fan?
Oh man, 12 rounds of tricks.
Oh, it goes a distance, you think?
12 rounds of tricks, I think,
Mm-hmm.
yeah.
Damn, that's fire.
Both of them tricky, man. Both of them smart.
And they gotta run it back. And
Both
they
of them
gotta run
strong.
it back.
Both of them strong. Yeah. That's a hell of, that's a damn good fight, if it should ever happen.
Should it be a rematch, a trilogy? Do you think it's that type of a thing for boxing? Do you think that if they gave us that, we would be spoiled? Or do you feel like it just falls in place?
I would let that one fight happen and leave it at that. If it's a draw, I wouldn't even rematch.
Whoa, you gotta tell me why.
They're two good fighters, man. Leave it at that.
Do you feel like it'll take a lot out of them as fighters at the end of the net? At like,
Yeah, I think
you did say it go 12, but does it become a stylistic war eventually?
yeah, very strategic war. I think both of them are smart. It won't be one of those fights where it's a war and they both getting banged up. It's just picking clean shots and outthinking each other, I don't think it'll take a lot out of either one of them because they're in shape and their defense is great. So it won't be one of them, one of them fights that take 4 years from a fighter,
It won't take too much out of them, you're
Nah,
saying?
they in great shape, man. They're smart. They're not gonna stand there and get hit like that.
So why a draw? We don't get the rematch. Coach, explain to me.
Because they just two good dudes, man. You gotta, if you know them
Yeah.
personally, I really don't want to see neither one of them lose.
You don't want them to lose their all.
Not to each other.
Not to each other.
They're great dudes, man.
I gotta lose it to another great.
I
It's how
know.
it is. It's what it's supposed to
I'm
be.
saying it might be another great after they fight, you know, but I don't think that they're gonna lose to nobody else.
That's what I'm saying. I don't think
So if
there's
it's a
nobody there.
draw, if it's a draw, leave it at that.
Leave it at that. And now
Leave it
we're
at that. Never.
all effed in the welterweight division for how long? Till Jalil Hackett
Hey,
till Jalil Hackett gets his shot.
that's it. Hope you know, by then I think Boots, he'd be growing up. They going up to 54. Then Jalil would be, you know, right there.
So, what you think about supposedly Barrios fighting Pacquiao?
I think Barrios will get him. Yeah, Barrios will get him.
Barrios will get him.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Like Barrios.
Yeah, Eddie Hearn said the same thing. Why do you say that? Past his
Yeah.
age?
Pacquiao, but he damn near old as Floyd. He older than Floyd, right? Yes, he.
He like probably 44.
No, Floyd is 47.
My bad. So he's a
He
I
got
think
it.
he's younger. He's younger than Floyd, but
Know he's
by like a
older.
year.
Yeah, he right there. So, and he's not athletic as Floyd, I don't think. Floyd's just a better sharpshooter than Pacquiao. I'm going with Barrios.
Is that a 50-50 or is that a 64? Like, what is that?
Pacquiao been KO'd, man. He was hurt bad, man. Devastating KO by a much smaller guy. So I think it's a possibility Barrios might clip him. You know?
Now, before I get into my next and last topic, I wanted to ask you, do you feel like the Jerron Ennis and Terrence Crawford fight will ever happen?
I think it will. I think it will between now and springtime. Especially I'm gonna say if, especially when Boots stopped this guy inside 5 rounds. You know, I think it'll happen.
I see Eddie Hearn hyping up Masvidal, the guy that Crawford's fighting. He's saying that Crawford's gonna lose.
Hell no. That's Crawford. Crawford a sharpshooter, man. This guy's a novice. Tough novice.
So,
know?
yeah. You think he's gonna get him
Yeah.
out?
Think he'll break him down. He'll get him out 9, 10, 11.
So, do you feel like the Crawford and Ennis fight will happen at 54?
Yeah, I think so. If the ghost Jason is great, you know, why not? I know one thing. Boots ain't gonna turn it down. And Crawford ain't. Crawford, man, he challenged you in everything, not just boxing. If you tell him you can beat him in a swimming pool, Olympic size, he jumping in that pool. If you can beat him running on feet, he gonna anything. He just competitive. He got a hit out on me because I beat him in a game of pool when he was a kid. He keep on saying, we gotta run that back. So eventually we're gonna run that back. Yeah, Crawford is fucking competitive, man. He ain't gonna turn down the challenge. And Boost is competitive too.
Right. And in that competitiveness, you know, Boots needs that name, right? But you know, today also, you know, it seems to me he's selling out pretty good. So, and he's probably the draw out of all the welterweights, right? So now coming into this fight, you know, when we look at these guys in stature, when we look at, you know, where Terrence Crawford has came down from, like, I think 130 to 35 pounds coming all the way up, when you have Jerron Boots Ennis, you know, you see that Crawford moved up But is that like a move just to say, let me collect that accolade, let me become a division champion or become welterweight because
yeah,
I
because
can do it.
He Crawford paid his dues, you know?
Yeah.
He did so much before they started talking about him in boots. So
yeah.
Why not move up again and make history? Collect that belt too.
Yeah, and he might even go undisputed at that weight class too.
Exactly. I mean, if it's possible, go for it, you know?
Right. But in that process, right, of saying that, Boots is big. How long can he really make 47? You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah,
so,
good question.
Like you said, he's very competitive. So does he go collect and be like, yo, I'll fight you, but we're doing it at 47, where I feel maybe more comfortable, and maybe you not feel more or less comfortable? Probably could be a discussion. What do you think?
I don't think Boots have no problem at all making 147.
Right. But what about in a year from now?
I don't think he'll have any problems, you know. He can still carry 54 good too, but because if you can shoot up past 54, walk around, whatever you walk around, you can come down, you know what I mean,
yeah,
to 54 or come back down to 47.